7 ways to save money. Now, this is the list that I use to save money during the week. It might not suit everybody, so hopefully you can get something from the list that you can use in your life as well. Number 1. Drink water. Sounds silly, right? How does drinking water have anything to do with saving money? Well, not only is water healthy, if you're drinking water, that means that you're not going out and buying coffee, you're not going out and buying soft drink, and you're not going out and buying tea. Now, some people at work, they buy maybe 2 cups of coffee a day at about, say, $8 or $10. Now, if you're doing that 5 times a week, that means you could save up to $50 a week just by not drinking coffee. Some people might have to wean themselves off their caffeine addiction, but ultimately it'll be good for you and you'll be saving money. Number 2. Eat at home. Sounds simple, right? Instead of going out and paying for costly restaurant meals, just go to the grocery store, set a budget, and buy your food from the grocery store. Prepare food at home. Not only is it probably healthy, depending on what you make, but it's also a good way to involve the family in preparing their own food. Our weekly grocery bill is only about $50 to $70 a week. Now, admittedly, I don't buy meat. I don't eat meat, so we're probably saving a fair bit there. But we're eating quite well. We're eating lots of healthy and fresh vegetables, cereals, rice, whatever it may be. You buy 10 kilograms of rice recently for like $12. It's a good way to eat. On the other hand, eating out is very expensive. You could spend easily $50 to $100 on my family if we went out and ate at a good restaurant. Sometimes we do eat out. I'm not saying you shouldn't eat out, but we usually go to somewhere where we can spend, say, $20 on the family. And there's plenty of restaurants around that can do that. Like, for example, there's a Thai place where we can just buy 2 dishes with rice, and that's enough to feed 2 adults plus our small children. Number 3. Don't buy brand name clothes. Now, don't trick yourself into thinking that more expensive clothes are made in better conditions. They're probably not. I think all clothes, regardless of whether they're brand name or otherwise, are made in either China, India, or Bangladesh. Furthermore, nobody really knows what clothes you're wearing. If you're wearing some famous brand, most people wouldn't have a clue that you're wearing them. If I'm wearing a Kmart t-shirt, again, most people wouldn't know. So don't think that the other people are going to be impressed by your selection of clothes. Maybe in some circles there's a little bit of that, but in general, people just don't know and don't care. As long as your clothes are well laundered, I think you may as well save yourself some money and just buy the no-name brands. Number 4. Cut your own hair. Of course, this doesn't suit everybody, but for a man like myself who's got fairly short hair, it's easy for me to cut my own hair. Just for this Christmas, actually, my wife bought me a new Val clipper set. It was only $24, and it's good quality, and it does the job. And it's pretty easy to cut your own hair or have your partner help you cut your own hair. I know some people who go out and spend $50 or even $100 getting their hair cut. Now, I don't know, if you're doing that, say, 10 times a year, that's a lot of savings that you could make. Recently, lots of people I know cut their own hair, and nobody notices, nobody cares. Nobody can look at somebody and go, "Oh, you've got your hair cut at so-and-so famous hairdresser." No, it just doesn't matter. As I said, it's probably not for everybody, but at least consider it. Number 5. Get out of debt, and don't use credit. This is a big one. This can save you a lot of money. I know lots of people who are in debt, and in multiple forms of debt. They've got personal loans, car loans, a mortgage, a student loan, hex debt as we call it here. If you can get out of debt, you'll be saving yourself a lot. All those interest repayments that you're making, that's truly dead money. You're just paying back a bank or a financial institution. What are they doing with that money? Well, they're just making profits from it, aren't they? Debt is a modern form of slavery. If you voluntarily get yourself into debt, that means you're voluntarily giving away 10 years of your life just to force yourself to work in order to pay back something that you really didn't probably need. My mum used to say, and my grandmother used to say, if you can't afford something, don't buy it. I think that's sound advice. It's pretty common sense advice, but nobody uses it much anymore. Many people love the feeling of getting a new credit card with a $10,000 maximum limit and then going out and buying a new TV set or whatever. It's a complete waste of money, and in the end you'll be paying a lot more for that TV set just by paying the extra interest rates. Often the first tip of many investors is to get out of debt first. It's very important. Number 6. Don't spend too much on depreciating assets. Now, a depreciating asset is one that, when you buy it, it starts losing value immediately. Things like cars and TVs and computers and so on. So when you buy a car, I'm sure you've all heard this old adage, as soon as you drive it out of the showroom, it basically loses 20% immediately. That is, you can't sell it for the same price that you bought it. And after 10 years, its price will have become almost negligible. So if you have a spare $50,000 lying around and you go out and buy a BMW or an Audi or whatever, then you're really wasting your money. You may as well be throwing that money away. Yeah, you'll get your car, maybe you'll get a good 5 years, 10 years of life from it, but then you got nothing left. You'll have another, your $50,000 has just disappeared. You might be able to get, say, $10,000 back if you're lucky. I'm not saying not to buy a car. If you need a car, you need a car, right? But you could probably buy something a bit more modest, such as a $15,000 car. As long as it gets you from A to B, or gets your family from A to B, then that's all you need, right? Some people are concerned about image. They worry what other people might think. They think by owning a BMW, others will look up to them. That's a whole lot of rubbish. Nobody cares. The number of BMWs and Audis and Mercedes-Benz that I see on the street now, it's ridiculous. They've become commonplace. So don't think that you'll be standing out by buying an Audi. Just buy a Mazda or a Toyota or a Mitsubishi or whatever. That's fine. Nobody will care, I promise you. Why spend $5,000 on the latest 4K curved screen TV set? You can get a good TV set for less than $1,000 nowadays. After 10 years, they're all worth nothing anyway. So don't bother wasting your money on depreciating assets. Just buy something modest. Number 7. Save and invest. If you follow my saving tips, then you should have some money left over every week to put in the bank. Now, you could choose to put it in a high-interest savings account, such as with UBank or whatever, or you could put a portion of your money into an investment fund, such as a Vanguard index fund. That's what I'm doing currently. All you need is $5,000 initial investment, and you can set up one of these funds, and they do all the management for you. You don't have to know anything about stocks or bonds or anything else. They'll manage it for you. There's plenty of different options for those who are less risk-averse, but if you want to try to get some gains, they've got growth options as well. Sure, you have to pay a fee, but it's only a minor fee. I think it's about 0.9%, which is reasonable in Australia. And ultimately, over time, your savings will compound, and you'll be getting more money. Your money will be working for you. And there you go, there are my 7 savings tips. I hope you got something from it, and I hope that you can implement some of them into your life and help your family save more money. There's no use spending all your money every week buying stuff that you don't need, and stuff that's just going to depreciate in value, like TVs and so on. Save your money, look after your family, think about the future, and you're well on your way to financial independence. Thank you for listening.